Well, here we are with a new piece of binding. I almost gooched myself. Well, I sort of did. See, we're going to call that aging. We're not done yet, but anyway, we're here. And the next step is to run the radius block across the fingerboard very gently. The binding, at the very end, when the guitar doesn't blow up, I'll age that a bit and attempt to blend it in a little more with the old binding. At least there's a binding. Your hand isn't going to get cheese grated. Let's continue. Big cleanup involved. Like I said, radius block across the fingerboard. And we're going to bend some wire and get this thing finished. So here I am, guys. And before we do any more work, we need to make sure that the wood portion of the program is as straight as it can be, right? You're not going to see this if I do it from that way. So that's fall away. And we hit the body joint, and this feeler gauge hits there, and she slides under there, and then we hit there, and it slides under there, and I'm thinking the truss rod could use another little turn. But like I said, at this point I don't trust my eye. That's why I use the feeler gauge against the straight edge. Okay, so we hit, that's better, it's tighter, tight, hitting. I love it. A little bit of gootry there, but that's nothing. Maybe I'll try just one more tiny turn. Not much, because this is mission critical. So I'm going to run the radius block over this in a minute. Fall away, body joint. I mean, we'll do it from this side. Body joint hitting. Still a little bit of hump in here, but we're going to sand that out. Hitting. And yeah, I'll roll with that. And I'll eyeball it just because I have eyeballs. Okay, so what are we going to do now? Radius block, 220 grit, and we will gently, and I mean gently, not to worry too much about that. That's a fall away. Creating a lot of nice rosewood dust. Good for your carcinogenic system. And I really don't want to take any more off than that. All I want to do is, there's usually little burrs where you pull the frets, and we want the new frets to sit really flat. It's going to be hard to tar. Will I suck the dust? Oh, and we just discovered another gooch. Thank you. So now, what I have just discovered is on the back side, the original binding is loose, so I have to fix that. So you see how it goes, guys? Two steps forward, one step back. Two step forward, one step back. Okay, so here I am. And we've done the radius block thing. I have realized that at some point, some sort of colorant or shit that's been put on here. Alright? You see all that? So I want to really do a good job of cleaning the fingerboard before we start banging frets. I'm tired. And tomorrow, well, I did glue that loose binding, but part of the problem with matching this binding is that there's no binding left. It's just like a thread from all the playing wear. And you know, if it was a real piece of binding, well, we'd be in business. So I had a bit of a gooch here and something fell off. I'm gonna call that, you know, aging, relicking. If the guitar doesn't blow up when I put strings on it and get it all built, what I will do is get some clear acrylic lacquer. Acrylic. Remember that. And I will tint it and then do a little bit of aging. See, I'm starting to get all that shit off there, whatever they put on the fingerboard at some point in time. It's coming off. Okay. So we get that going. Oh no, I'll have to oil the fingerboard just like the lady at Gibson does at the end. Right, like in the video where they do the tour and she's doing the final polish on the frets. And she oils the rosewood. But no, don't do that on your own. You know, I digress, right? Because it's, and most guys don't get it. It's like, it's a once a year thing. And you don't, like, paint it on and let it fucking dry. Sorry, I said the F word. You don't do that. You wipe it on and you wipe it off. And some folks will tell you, oh, don't do that. But what that does is it keeps the good stuff in and the bad stuff out. Right? A few drops, wipe it in, wipe it off once a year. Not every time you change the frickin' strings. Because now you're marinating the thing, right? You're pickling it. And that's the point to ponder. Oh, look, I spooged. I spooged on the fingerboard. I think I've got most of that out of there. What's going to happen tomorrow? We're going to clean all the nut slots and the fret slots and every slot that needs to be cleaned. And we're going to roll some wire. And then we're going to start putting these in. These will require a little nibbling to get past the binding, right? So that's why, you know, an unbound fingerboard is more economically refretted, because you just cut them, bang them in, clip them off. This is like each one I have to do one at a time. What do you think? Did I get all that shit off there? I think so. Look at that. It could be good, boys. It could be good. My little nut slut. This thing works great because not only does it check to see if the slot's deep enough, it actually cleans things. But the other problem with this is that cleaning these slots, if you start banging in that direction, you're gonna split the binding. So that's why it costs more to do one like this. This is looking great. Like, everything's nice and clean. This thing slides in beautifully, as it should. And we are checking the depth here right now. I'll go down here in the movie. It's beautiful. The guys that, I hate to say it, but the Evil Empire came out with this. That's a beautiful little tool. There is another way to do this old school, but this guy seems to rock it. So, and there's a reason I don't do a lot of videos about these type of repairs, is because for me, it's very zen. I like to just get into it and do it, focus on it, and unless you actually do it a whole bunch of times, the process only presents itself with each opportunity. So like I said, refretting this guitar is totally different than a Stratocaster or a bolt-on neck or they're all different. And as you pull it apart or put it back together, in this case, you begin to come up with different issues that just present themselves. So I'm going to keep cleaning and having fun here, and tomorrow we'll roll some wire and bang some new rails into this baby.